We have the cattle in the yard here, but in most circumstances, before we get the cattle in the yards, we've got to get them out of the paddock. So simple steps by planning and thinking about what you're doing can prevent delays and or injuries occurring. Their instinctive behaviour is what drives them to behave the way that they behave, and this has been the case for thousands of years. In simple, for cattle, there are two things that they need to think about that is the basis for their survival, and that is, where are their mates and where is the predator? And then in this case, we can be potentially the predator. What we're trying to show you is best practices, that is using the animals or livestock's behaviour to move them to where we want to go. In relation to communicating with the animals, our position in relation to what they can see is very, very important. We are going to illustrate the importance of parallel movement, that is moving parallel to the animal but in the opposite direction speeds them up, and moving parallel to the animal in the same direction slows them down. Mostly we're going to speed them up or get them to go in the direction that we want. It is very important that we understand that animals like to curve around us. They curve around us because they always want to see us. We need to make sure that we're inside the curve when we're moving the animals. So let's go in the yards and move the livestock from one pen to the other. We're moving the cattle from yard to yard, so when we do this, we need to influence a leader. So instead of going to the back, we can initiate the movement by getting the first few cattle to go where we want them to go. Using movement and position. Righto, now I've got my leaders. The other animals can see where I want them to go. I can now use parallel movement and my body position to regulate the flow of cattle and how many I want. If I go forward, in the opposite direction, they will speed up. If I go parallel but in the same direction, they will slow down. When working with gates, it is always safer to work at the end of the gate when you're operating the gate, opening or closing. Never stand behind the gate, whether the gate is closed or whether the gate is open. Should something hit the gate, of course the gate, even if you're holding it, will hit you. When opening and closing gates, we need to consider, do we open the gate outwards or inwards? Which best fits the situations? There's pros and cons for both. If I move the gate outwards or towards where the livestock are coming in, this means that I can close the gate more quickly or timely in this instance when the cattle go in there. However, this gate is not fitting snug against the rail. So this means that it could potentially pose a risk to the cattle. So in this instance, I'm going to face it in the direction that the livestock are moving. I need to consider how many livestock do I need? How big is my yard? This will reduce the risk of injury to myself and to livestock. As the yards get smaller, the pressure increases and can change the livestock behaviour. As a general rule, in high pressure yards, you are best to fill the yard only 50%. So, going to choose 10 animals. Get the lead to go. And exactly the same parallel movement as beforehand. I can use my visual aid to assist me in what I'm doing. One important fact about slide gates is they can assist us with livestock movement, but they can also be very dangerous. When you're opening a slide gate, you need to work on the side of the slide gate, not directly behind it. If you work directly behind the gate when you pull it or close it, if the animal rushes forward, it can send the gate flying backwards towards you and cause a very serious injury. When going from one end of the yard to the other, you do not have 50 choices. Usually there is either two or three. I go to the left, to my right, or straight through the cattle. When considering which direction you need to go, consider your safety and which one sets you up to influence the cattle easily through the next movement or next gateway. Just like before, I get the lead animals to go. One, two, three, four, five. Whilst I'm closing the gate, I'm now keeping my eye on two mobs of cattle. I'm now going to go and get the next gate, and the cattle, just sheerly by me getting the gate, will go back to where they came in and see that the gate is closed. When I'm moving in a pen of cattle, I do not rush or try and frighten the cattle or have sudden movements. I move gradually and slowly so the cattle can see me and have time to move around me. I'll just go down here and open up my slide gate. Just like before, I get the leader. Make sure that there's some followers to come. Use parallel movement. And when the cattle are going in the desired direction, there's no need for me to chase them or put any more pressure on. So I go around to the animal's eye where it can see me and ask it to go forward. I move in the opposite direction and they go forward. Note that when we are working the race and using parallel movement, we should not stand too close to the race in case the animals kick out. We should also not put our hands in here or carry out any routine husbandry practices because we could end up with a broken arm or a broken hand. I'm now going to put the cattle in the chute. I'm not going to catch them, ear tag them or do anything like that. I'm just going to put them in the crush or the chute and let them out. I use my parallel movement to go. She goes in, I close this slide gate. In case she comes out before I get to this one, I then close this one. When operating the crush, and in particular the head bale, make sure that you stand well clear of the lever. Stand to either one side or the other and make sure that you do not have your head over. When you also open the crush, make sure that you open it properly so that you do not injure or bruise the cow or the animal inside. So up, I can move over here and let her come out, and there she goes. This heifer here has a bit more movement in her. She's probably got a larger flight zone, but the principles are exactly the same. Applying and releasing pressure, opening and closing the gates in a set order. And making sure that I do not have my head above the handle. This heifer is examining what's going on in there in the crush. I give her time to assess the situation. She may come back because the gate's closed there. I'm going to come to her now, ask her to move forward. She does so. I stop my movement, she gets a reward, and now I'm going to let her out.